Hi everyone, Said here. I hope you are doing great. We usually say use this formula in this problem, use that formula in that situation. But today I'm going to tell you don't use formula in these situations. So without any further ado, let's get started. We have a list which the first names and last names are written separately in different cells. Now, we want to write these names together in one cell. To do this, you can use the formula. In this cell, I write equal, concat, and double-click on the formula. I want to concatenate this cell to this cell. So I select first name, comma, and I add a space, comma, and finally, I select this cell and press Enter. Now, if I drag this cell down, everything looks good. But what if I tell you there is an easier solution for this? Let me Ctrl Z to undo that. In the set of formula, I want to use the flash fill feature. So in this cell, I write Said Faal and drag it down. By default, Said Faal copies to other cells. But if you click on fill option icon, you can select the flash fill option, boom. Excel automatically recognizes your pattern and fills other cells with the pattern. This feature is really good, but unfortunately, it is not dynamic. I mean, if I change my last name in English means active. So I write active in this cell, and you see it didn't change in this cell. You can even use it in reverse order. This time I want to write first and last names in separate cells. I type Said in this cell and drag it down and select flash fill. But let me show you another method. First, let me delete these. I type Said in this cell and I type James. Do you see that? Excel automatically recognizes your pattern and suggests you the rest of it. If you press Enter, Excel writes your pattern into the other cells. For the last name, I want to use the shortcut key, which is Ctrl E. So I type my last name and select the below cell and press Ctrl E. Excel automatically applies flash fill to other cells. In this example, if you look at the names precisely, you can see that some names are lowercase and some of them are uppercase and some of them are capital. But I want to write all of them in the capital, so I write Said Faal and press Ctrl E. Excel merged the first and last names, but it couldn't change them all to capital. In fact, only first names have become capital, but it couldn't make any changes to the last names. Can you tell me why? To answer that, you need to look at Said Faal. We changed Said from lowercase to capital, but Faal was capital already, and we wrote it down like it was before. And because of that, Excel thought you don't want to make any changes to the last names. And if you look at the results, the last names in all the cells haven't changed. For solving this problem, let me delete all the results. Now I have to find a way to tell Excel that I want to change the last name to capital as well as the first name. So I change Faal to lowercase in this cell, and now I write Said Faal in capital in this cell. Now Excel knows the pattern. It should change the first and last name to capital. I press Ctrl E. Do you see that? Everything is as we want it. In this section, I want to create a new email for all the new students. I type Said Faal underline and press Enter. Now, if I press Ctrl E, new email will be created for all the new students. Isn't it awesome? I don't believe that any formula can do that for you. Sometimes Excel don't understand your pattern. For example, I want to separate the metal type and its grade, so I write aluminum and press Ctrl E. Okay, looks good. Now I want to separate the grade, so I type A and press Ctrl E. But Excel thought you meant the first letter of the metals and wrote them down. For making Excel understand that you meant the grade, you need to give Excel more information. First, let me delete these, and I type B in this cell, and press Ctrl E again. This time, Excel returns the grades correctly. You can use Flash Fill for all types of formats. Here we have year, month, and day. If I type out first date and use Ctrl E, Excel combines the remaining cells. I hope you find all of these examples helpful. Please like and subscribe to the channel and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. And leave comments about additional tips you would like to see covered in the channel. All right, it was all for today's video. I'll see you in next video.